Hello, everybody. It's David Clausen with English-Quickly.com, and we have an exciting week in learning English from the best. We're going to go back to Buenos Aires. We got a great best-selling book, Love Song. They are always popular. A fun animated movie, A Stroll in the Park. I will talk about that later, and much, much, much more. So let me share my screen here, and we will learn some English and have a little fun from the best of the week. So let me pull that up here. I will hit share. Let me double check. Make sure I'm presenting to everyone. You can hear, I think my audio is good. And we will start with the number one song of the week. Let me just double check one thing, make sure. Okay, that looks good. Samari here, Kamal is here. Thank you, Kamal. And thanks, Samra, for being here. I will turn my Skype on. So let me click online. Let's see. Got a message here. Just want to make sure. I got from Stella. Okay, Stella, let me give the event here. Let me say thanks to Stella. I sent that off. Let me see one more here. Okay, Stella, I got your message. I'll try to call you. Just so you know, my house, our bathroom is getting a remodel, or well, a little bit. That's not our bathroom. I'll put tile. So this is tile, or I should put construction. Right now, our bathroom is getting remodeled. So you might hear some noise, and my internet might not be working, or problems and stuff. So that, just to let you know. My Skype, if you want to call me during this broadcast, it's dclausen_2. And right here, you can call me. Let me make that bigger. So dclausen_2, if you have any questions, or you can I have this chat here. You can write a question. Samory writes, sir, do you remember my suggestion last week? Yeah, I think with talking back, I put yes. Feel free to ask a question here or on Skype. So hopefully, Samaria, you will get that. I will check with that if you have any questions. And I think we will get started. I will look at my Skype to see if there's anything, but I think we are good. So let's start. All right, the number one movie of the week, it's called Big Hero 6. It made $56,200,000. Not bad, huh? And it is robotics prodigy Hiro Hamada learns to harness his genius thanks to his brilliant brother, Tadashi, and their like-minded friends. Okay, so it's about robotics. So if you're not sure, this is a robot. So here's a robot. And here's another picture of it with the plot. So we have Hiro Hamada, Japanese, lives in the futuristic city of San Francisco. It's a combination of San Francisco and Tokyo. He is a 14-year-old robotics genius who spends his part-time participating in back alley robot fights. So there's fights, you know, robot fights. See what comes up. You know, see, these robots are fighting robots. So that could be kind of fun. And let's see here. Someone called and I wasn't sure. So let's see here. Not sure who called. So if they call back, I will try to answer. Okay, so Robot Fights, that is Big Hero 6, the number one movie of the week. And its release date was October 23rd. And that was in the Tokyo International Film Festival. And November 7th in the United States. It took $165 million, the budget to make the film. Okay, let's go on to music. We've done this song. Shake It Off is the number one song of the week. I've done that a few weeks back. We've done All About the Bass, Animals, Habits, Bang Bang, and Hot Boy, and this one is Love Me Harder by Ariana Grande and The Weeknd. So let's give you a little tune. So, if you want to keep her, basically, you have to love her harder. So, because if you want to keep me, you gotta love me harder. And if you really need me, you gotta love me harder. You got to love me harder. So basically, you have to give more of your love. So she wants more. A lot of times, women want more love and the guy doesn't. So it's young love. It can be volatile. We'll listen to a little bit more of the tune here. So when I get you moaning, you know it's real. Can you feel the pressure between? So it's a lot of sex and love and young love. So Love Me Harder by Ariana Grande. Okay, let's go on to the New York Times bestseller, the number one movie, the number one book of the week, The Burning Room. And this is The Burning Room by Michael Connelly. And it is a murder book. So in the new thriller from number one New York Times bestselling author Michael Connelly, Detective Bosch and his rookie partner investigate a cold case that gets very hot very fast. So it's a murder or an investigation. So if you have a police investigation, they're looking for clues. If I type in murder investigation, they're looking for a murder. So sometimes they'll say, they call this, it's a case, a crime scene. It's a police case, so it's something that they're working on. It's what they are doing, the case. And so when they say a cold case, it means they don't have much evidence. And in this case, in this book, it turns into a hot case, meaning there's problems with this murder. And it's politically sensitive, so it has to do with some politics. Politics is like with government. So if we have politics, that's politician politics, and it has to do with government and power. So that's the number one book, The Burning Room. And let me just see if we have any okay, Samaria, let's see here. Okay. Here you go. Samaria, my Skype account is there. So hopefully you see that, Samaria. And I'm not sure if I have you in Skype. So hopefully that will come out. So hopefully he sees that. Okay, let's move on to last week. We went to Buenos Aires, Argentina. So let me type that in, Buenos Aires, Argentina, and that is in the continent of South America. Let's just do a quick reminder of some of the photos we can see of Buenos Aires. Very beautiful. You can see, very big city. See if something comes up. There we go. Plaza Lavalle. Be a very beautiful place to check out. And let me back out a little bit so you get an idea. South America. So here is Argentina, Brazil. Here's Africa, Europe. in the United States up here. I'm in Colorado. So kind of a fun place, Buenos Aires. And last week we talked about some of the highlights in transportation. So let's talk about some of the things you can do there. Pull that up. And let's see. I get a call. Let's try. Hello?
Hello.
Hi, is this Samaria?
Yeah, I'm from Sri Lanka.
Oh, how are you?
Fine, sir.
Good, good. Can you,
So do you remember my suggestion last week?
Was that with, grammar? Mm-hmm.
Yeah, actually, I had some, new thing, called, something daily conversation.
Yeah, well, I don't have time for daily conversation. I teach in a school, so I won't be able to do that. So, but if you have a question, you can ask me here.
Okay, fine.
Well, what's your question?
No, sir, I'm still watching your lesson. Then lastly, I will ask you a question.
Okay, so why don't... Good, okay, I'll hang up, and then I'll finish up here, and then... call me back if you have any questions.
Okay, sure, sir.
Okay, all right.
Thank you, bye.
Bye-bye. Okay, so that was Simaria. I hope you can hear the call. I hope it comes out okay, the technology and stuff. So, so we were at Buenos Aires, and... Let's take a look at some things to do there. If I can find, there's so many things that it's difficult to talk about, you know. So I just want to find the big things, and I think I went too much. Let me go up. Let me see if I can find it. Let's see here. To see. And usually they have something to do, but here they don't. So let's go with C. So, and we talked about it last week. So we have the tango street art. Let's take a look at this, a gaucho party. Spend a night seeing what it is like to be a real gaucho. So live the life of an Argentine cowboy. So you ride horses, eat traditional gaucho foods. So let's take a look at this. Gaucho foods. G-A-U-C-H-O foods. And so it has a lot of meat. Looks like tomatoes. Some nice bread. Steak. French fries. So this is like rancher food or gaucho food. That looks good. This is broccoli, corn, rice. And so that would be a fun thing to do in Buenos Aires. Skydiving, if you're not sure, this is skydiving. So if you like crazy stuff, you can go skydiving. Excuse me. I had to sneeze there. We call that in English a sneeze. So I'll pull that up. That's to sneeze. Excuse me. I had to sneeze there. And they got food tours. So you can go on a tour of food, wine events. Polo and helicopter tours. golf, spas. If you're not, this is a fun one. I'll put in spas if you're not sure. So there's a nice spa to relax. That's fun to go into the spa. Some of the fun festivals. Let me type this. Buenos Aires City Festivals. Let's see if we get anything that will come up. Yeah, so they these be festival celebration in the cities. So that's, you know, a great place. Buenos Aires, Argentina, a great place to check out. And that was our Wikipedia. I'll just show you. Wiki Travel, it's called. From here, and it was the destination of the month, Buenos Aires. So kind of fun to see place here at Wiki Travel. Let's take a look at our daily infographic. And this has to do with alcohol and weight gain. So you'll hear that in English, weight gain. And so to gain weight is to put on pounds in America, we say, or kilograms. So weight gain, and alcohol is like beer and wine. So alcohol and weight gain. Your metabolism is how your body processes things. So alcohol is ingested, or you drink it. Alcohol is metabolized, and the fat oxidation stops, or it doesn't burn fat. And if you're not sure what fat is, this is fat on the body. So we have fat there. Okay, so the fat doesn't burn. And then you have weight gain over time. So alcohol has 7 calories per gram. That's almost the same as pure fat. So it's just like eating fat. It has calories like a blueberry muffin. This is a muffin, or a donut, or a slice of cake. And so it changes your metabolism, we call that, the way your body processes. So alcohol accounts for 10% of the daily calorie intake in adults. So adults get a lot of calories from alcohol. These are better alcohol, vodka, light beer, gin and tonic, or red wine. So, you know, you got to watch the alcohol, the beer, and the wine that you do drink. Let's take a look at National Geographic photo of the day, a funny face, two fish kissing. And this, and I'm getting, so this comes from Bengali, and let me type in Bengal. It's on the east coast of India. Let's see here. I'll type it in so we can all see where it is. And it should be in India. It's a province. Let me double check. It's on the east coast of India. So Bengali. Bangalore should be over here on the east coast. Let me type in Bengali, India. And they're giving me something else, but It's basically, it's over here on the east coast of India, and they have this wedding ceremony, and in it, two fish kiss, and that is, you know, a fun little photo to check out, a funny face from National Geographic. And our learner's word of the day is to stroll, which basically means to walk. They are strolling in the park. To stroll is to walk slowly in usually a pleasant and relaxed way. It's a relaxed way to walk, you know, a couple strolling in the park. They strolled along the street looking in the store windows. We strolled the streets of the village. He went for a stroll through the park. So it's kind of a nice thing to do is to stroll. So let me just see if we have any. Amir is from Iran. Hello, Amir.
Oops.
Oh, good. Samira, Bengali is near my country, and he is in Sri Lanka. Your Skype ID here show we can talk over Skype. Good. I'm going to say hello, Amir, from Iran. He is watching. And if anybody has any questions, if Samira, you have a question, feel free to call me on Skype. Those of you, let me go back. Not sure. My Skype is dclawson_2 on Skype. Hopefully you can find that. And I'll give this a couple of minutes to see if people get that. My Skype. I know there's a delay. Amir says hi. I'll say, how is the weather? The weather in Iran. So, you know, the weather in Colorado, it's been very cold. I'll just show you where I'm at. Denver, Colorado. So here's where I am. We've had very low weather. Denver weather. It's been 6 degrees Fahrenheit, minus 14 degrees Celsius. It's been very, very, very cold here. I mean, we get cold weather, but not this much. If we look at the mountains, I'll show you a place that many people ski. Been getting a lot of snow. So that's good. Show you the weather. So they've been getting a lot of snow, up in over 3 feet of snow this week in the mountains. So it's been very, very cold here. So I hope this is working. I'll just stay on one more minute if anybody has any question. If Samira, you have a question, feel free to call. I hope this is working. My internet hasn't been the best lately. I don't know why. It's been slow. And I look at it, the screen isn't that good. So, take a look at anything else. Going back from all of the things. So, okay, I think I will end the broadcast. I appreciate everybody being here. I hope it worked out. You could see it all. Let me come in here. Thank you so much for watching. Let me set up next week so you can check that out. I'll program that in now. So I will click new live event. I'll put in learn English from the best things from the week. I'll put it in for the 23rd. I'll do it for 7 a.m. my time. And I will make it public. I will create the event. And here is the link. I'll paste the link into my Facebook page so people can check it out for next week. And click post so you can click that. And I think that should do it. So let me get that white balance in a little bit. Yep, there we go. All right, so thank you so much for being here. I hope you have a great week, and we will talk to you later. Take care. Bye-bye.